Welcome to Altair Engineering Training and Support. In this video, I am going to cover the SAE Supra 2013 or 2014 roll cage using 1D mesh, how to interpolate the results and how to do the rendering, that is how to change the background images stuff. So we will start with the Hyperview process. So to open Hyperview, go to Start, All Programs, Altair HyperWorks, Hyperview. Once you click on Hyperview, it will open the Hyperview GUI. It will show you this license warning. So just click close to it. So this is the Hyperview GUI. So once the Hyperview GUI opens, click on Open Folder, select Load Model, browse the location where you have saved the model. So it's 1D analysis. I will use the same result file which in the earlier video I have created the 6 different analysis. So as you can see, so as the earlier one, we have 6 different analysis, that is front impact, side impact, torsional bump, rollover and normal model. So I will use the same image, same result file. So to view the results of displacement and stress, click on contour. So this icon is contour icon. So click on contour. In contour option, select the result type as displacement and click on apply. So this will show you the displacement values. If you don't want to view these in the scientific way, you can directly click on edit legend. From the value and color numeric format scientific to fixed, say apply and OK. So instead of this, so you can see it in a numerical way. I will again show you. You just click on edit legend on the bottom on the same contour page and you can edit here just from the numeric format scientific to fixed, say apply and OK. So it will move to a numeric values. Now if you want to see the value where the maximum displacement is coming as, so you can just click on measure icon. This icon is used as the measure icon. Check the box in front of static mean max, as these are the static results. So check the box in front of static mean max of the minimum one. So here you can find that this is the static maximum value, that is 1.352. If you don't want to get the three values up to 3 decimal place, so you can lower it down to 1.4 something from here, from this you can increase the values or you can decrease the value. Okay, so also you can off this. If you don't want this thing, you can also off this. So go to, on the model browser, go to nodes, model info. So in this way it will be off. That is the model info, where is your file stuff. So now I will show you how to capture the images for to put it in the presentations. So to capture the images, there are different options available in Hyperview itself. But the best option is to capture it by dragging the window, by selecting the window you want to capture. So we'll use that particularly. Just click on this and from one end to another drag a window. I will name it as front impact. and save it in a desktop. So if I minimize this, you can see. You can see that the image has been captured. So we can put this same image in the presentation directly, as I can see here. You can directly put this image in the presentation. If you magnify it, it will be, you can see this in this way. Now I will move towards the rendering portion. So in this way you can capture the different images. So now I will move to the rendering option. Similarly, in the same way you can move or you can get the images of side impact by creating this. Desktop. Side impact. This is the side impact. Just copy and paste it in a presentation. So in this way, the side impact is done. Now you can also find the values of displacement for torsional, or if you want to find the values of stresses, go to result, again go to contour, displacement, elemental stresses, select C-bar, CP, maxial stresses, averaging method to simple and say apply. So these are the values of stresses. We can find easily the values of that and then capture the images in the same way. Desktop. Torsional analysis. You can open this. Paste it here. So these are the values, or these are the images of different analysis. So in this way you can capture these types of images directly from the hyperview and paste it on your presentation. Or else there is one more way of doing the advanced rendering, that is changing the background to improve or to visually improve the results, so that your results will be more attractive to view. So that is also possible in Hyperview. I will show you that. Now I will show you how to change the desktop, the background of Hyperview. That I will show you. So to change the background of the Hyperview, click on this icon. This icon is named as image panel. Then in the image panel, select the type as 2D. Image label, you can name it as whatever you want to name. Then file type, click on open. Browse the location where you have different images. So as I have downloaded some of the images from the this, and now you can change it from here. Also you can decrease the size of these images, or the other way is you can directly change the background by going to open Microsoft PowerPoint, open different images, say for example I will open this image, say copy and paste it here. Then again go to this and open the Altea's logo, paste that here. You can group them and save as picture. in the desktop, say Altair image. Now go to Hyperview, go to results and delete this. We will import another one. Again click on this image panel, go to files, desktop, select Altair image and say open. This will import the image and you can just move it to the right hand side. And then you can put the image of your roll case structure or any model here. Or if you don't want to put this like a static maximum minimum value, you can just simply off it. With the nodes also you can put some nodes here. So go to nodes to put the nodes, or go to nodes, click on add. Don't click on anchor to nodes so that you can move these node. And you can just untick anchor to screen and you can write it down here as this is the result for torsional analysis. Maximum stress is 151.4 Newton per mm square and factor of safety. Is, if I consider that as a steel, so it's somewhere around 2. So you have to calculate that and say apply. So in this way, you can also make a note here in the Hyperverse GUI itself. Or you can move this to fit to the screen. And then again click on capture image from this end to this end. Again on the desktop, torsional, you can also change the format. So this is the torsional, I will again capture the image from this end to this end. You can capture the image, desktop, torsional, save. Then copy and you can just paste it in the PPT. If I delete this. So in this way, you can capture the images. I will bring this one also here, so it will be easy to find the difference. So you can see in this way you can put the results, like changing the background so it will be more attractive and more reliable to view. Also you can put some notes here like torsional analysis, maximum stress is this, factor of safety is somewhat. Then also you can put like displacement, maximum displacement is this. So you can put a notes here, also you can put the images and the Altair logo of course. And in this way you can just use the common version of Hyperview and you can just capture the images. So these are the different ways to capture the images and rendering. So I will again delete this and show you some animation plots. So how to view the animation. Also I will off this note. So now I will show you how to animate this model. So to animate this model, first select a linear, set linear animation mode, click on apply. So in this way you can see the animation. If If you go to deformed, if the animation is very less, so you can maximize it. The value will be same, just it's a magnified way to view the animation. In the same way, you can just change it to bump analysis, to rollover analysis. These are the modal analysis. First mode, second, third, fourth. So these are the four modes, four different modes. Then the front impact. So in this way, I have ended with the different options available in Hyperview to capture the images, to view the results, to interpolate the results. So in this way, you can capture the images or view the results. So there are different way options available in Hyperview. So in this way, I'll end this video. Thank you.